الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وإنا له لحافظون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh meaning may the peace, mercy and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is answering allegations against a hadith. Another question is from hadith rejector is that are there no weak hadith or incorrect hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim? The question is are there no weak hadith or incorrect hadith in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim? In another words, is there a consensus amongst the muhaddithin that all the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim are sahih? In the response of it, inshallah, in the course of my talk, I will try to explain and answer this allegation with evidences and proofs that the book Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, the book covers almost all aspect of life in providing proper guidance of Islam, such as the method of performing prayers and other actions of worship directly from the Islamic Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bukhari finished his work around 846. Please write down all this information. Inshallah, you will get and you will understand. If not now, inshallah, later you can understand it very well. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah finished his work around 846 Christian era and spent the last 24 years. Imagine 24 years of his life visiting other cities and scholars teaching the ahadith he had collected. In every city that he visited, thousands of people would gather in the main mosque to listen to him recite traditions. In reply to Western's academic doubts as to the actual date and authorship of the book that bears his name, scholars point out that notable hadith scholars of that time, such as Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. Imagine, the error is highly improbable. There is no probability of error, because at the time of Imam Bukhari rahimullah, the prominent scholars were there. Who are they? Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayh, 855 Christian era. Imam Yahya bin Ma'in rahmatullah alayh, 847 Christian era. Ali bin Madini rahmatullah alayh, 848 Christian era. Imagine, these are very prominent muhaddithin were there at the time of Sahih al-Bukhari, at the time of compiling Sahih al-Bukhari. They accepted the authenticity of his book, and that the collection's immediate fame make it unlikely that it could have been revised after the author's death. During this period of 24 years, Bukhari made minor revision to his book, notably the chapter headings. Each version is named by its narrator, according to Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahmatullah alayh. In his book, nukat. The number of hadith in all version is the same. The most famous one today is the version narrated by Al-Firabli. Al-Firabri. 932 Christian era. A trusted student of Bukhari, Khatib al-Baghdadi, in his book, History of al-Baghdad, quoted Firabri as saying about 70,000 people heard Sahih Bukhari with me. And these people were muhaddisin. And no one deny. They did not deny about Sahih al-Bukhari. Firabri is not the only transmitter of Sahih al-Bukhari. There were many others that narrated the book to later generation. Best known, there are many books that noted differences between these versions. And the best sharah and the interpretation of Sahih al-Bukhari is Fath al-Bari. Fath al-Bari has been written by Hafiz Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahmatullah alayh. The Sahih of Imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad bin Ismail al-Bukhari is the soundest book of narration after the book of Allah, after the Quran. The scholars, muhaddithun, scholar of the hadith, and hafiz who memorized the ahadith, all bear witness to its high status in terms of authenticity and precision. Al-Hafiz Abu Amr bin As-Salah said, in Siyanat Sahih Muslim, page number 86, with his isnad, going back to Imam Al-Haramain Al-Juwayni, that he said, if any man were to swear that he would divorce his wife, if it were not the case that what is in the books of Al-Bukhari and Muslim is what they rule to be sound of the words of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, blessing of Allah be upon him, then divorce would not be binding upon him, and he would not be breaking his oath, because the Muslim scholars are unanimously agreed that they are Sahih. If we are talking about Sahih al-Bukhari, authenticity of Sahih al-Bukhari, so we have to understand carefully. This is not a far-fetched, because al-Bukhari is the great Imam and Hafiz to whose memory and position all the muhaddithun bore witness. He used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance by praying istikara and pray two rakah concerning every hadith he included in his book until he completed in his this manner. Even though we are aware that there are some minor criticism leveled at a few ahadith that are recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari, we are certain that there is nothing wrong with applying the label of Sahih to all these ahadith in the book for the following reason. And in all those allegations, Imam Bukhari rahimahullah, alhamdulillah, is correct in his opinion, alhamdulillah. We can give the reason why Sahih Bukhari is correct, alhamdulillah. Number one reason is most of the scholar and muhaddithun think that Imam al-Bukhari is in the right with regard to matter for which he was criticized. It is well known that it is not correct methodology to accept criticism just because it exists, rather than it depends on evidence and proof. Al-Hafiz Ibn Hajar, may Allah have mercy on him, in his great book Fath al-Bari, and especially in his introduction which is called Hadith Sari, discuss the answer to these minor criticism, and explain what is correct. Alhamdulillah. This is the opinion of scholars. Alhamdulillah. Hafiz Ibn Hajar rahimahullah collected all those opinion in Hadith Sari, introduction of Fathul Bari. And second reason is why Imam Bukhari, why Sahih Bukhari is correct, why we are believing that Sahih Bukhari is correct. The second reason is the number of ahadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, including repetitions according to the numbering of Muhammad Fuad Abdul Baqi, may Allah have mercy on him, is 7563. When we realize that the number of criticism is less than 20, the number of criticism is less than 20, and that most of those criticism have to do with matter concerning the isnad, or whether the hadith reaches the highest level of sahih, or they have to do with one or two words in a hadith, and that the criticism which have to do with matters affecting the soundness of the matan text are rare, but there is no room, there is nothing, and affects no more than one or two or three hadith, but the correctness, alhamdulillah, lies with Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. When we know all that, we realize that applying the label of Sahih to everything that is in al-Bukhari, in Sahih al-Bukhari, text and isnad, is correct and cannot be denied. Imam an-Nawawi rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, said, the Ummah is unanimously agreed that these two books are Sahih, and it is obligatory to follow their ahadith. Tadhib al Asma wal Lughat, volume number 1, Tadhib al Asma wal Lughat, volume number 1, page number 73. And Shaykh al Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, there is no book beneath the canopy of heaven that is more sound than al-Bukhari and Muslim after the Quran. End quotes. Quotes of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, ending here. This has been mentioned in Majmu' al-Fatawa, volume number 18 and page number 74. And Al-Hafiz Ibn Hajar said, answering criticism of Sahih al-Bukhari, the answer to that, okay, understand? Do you understand? The answer to that in general term is, there is no doubt that al-Bukhari and the Muslim are superior to the people of their own era, and the imams of this branch of knowledge who came after them in finding out what is sahih or sound and what is mu'allal or faulty. The scholars did not differ concerning the fact that Ali ibn al-Madini was the most knowledgeable of his peers about ilal al-hadith, faults of hadith, and that al-Bukhari learned that from him. He used to say, I did not feel myself inferior to anyone except Ali bin al-Madini. Nevertheless, when Ali al-Madini heard about al-Bukhari, saying that, he said, ignore what he says, for he has never seen anyone like himself. He is praising Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. Muhammad bin Yahya al-Duhali, you know, very prominent scholar in hadith, in the field of hadith, was the most knowledgeable of his era about faults in the hadith, ilal al-hadith, faults in ahadith of, you know, Dhuhriyat, Dhuhli. And both of the two sheikhs, Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, learned that from him. Al-Firabri narrated that Bukhari said, I did not include any ahadith in Sahih until after I prayed istikhara. I prayed istikhara, asking Allah for guidance and being certain of its soundness. Makki bin Abdullah said, I heard Muslim Ibn Hajjaj says, I showed this book